empty.
Hey guys, my name is Evan and welcome to Country View Acres. So today is the start of firewood season here. I'm gonna start splitting some firewood, start cutting down some trees. I normally do that here in the winter time. And what we're splitting today is firewood that we cut down last winter, about 9 months ago. And we've had it piled here in front of the firewood pile. We're finally getting around to splitting it. So this firewood we're splitting today is not for us to burn this year. This is for us to split and stack, and then we'll burn it next year or the year after. We're gonna let it sit and dry and season. What we're burning this year is this wood pile back here that's been split. Most of that you see has been sit there and split for 2 years and been 2 years drying. So it's very seasoned. We have an EPA wood stove. If you buy one of the newer wood stoves, you really need to have dry wood, seasoned wood. It needs to be probably dried for a year or more to burn the best in the newer wood stoves. Ours is actually a fireplace insert that heats our house. So it's like a wood stove, but it just fits into the wall. You put stone around it, it kind of looks like a fireplace, but it heats the house. So what we split today was hickory. There's some hickory trees we cut down to widen the entrance to our hay field last year so that we could get some farm equipment through. And that's what we were splitting up today. We were getting that hickory split up. We need to stack it still. It'd be nice to get that stacked and underneath the woodshed. But then it was right in the way of being able to get to the seasoned firewood. So I want to get that seasoned firewood today. I want to get it up to the house, get it stacked at the house. I need to get some kindling together and get everything ready so that we can start heating with wood this year. So there's a lot of ways you can tell whether your firewood's dry. Some people go by the sound or by the weight of it. So I just split this one open a second ago, and I've got what they call a moisture meter to be able to test this wood. So this moisture meter, it has two prongs where you just poke it into the wood, and it's reading about 15% moisture right now. And this has been drying for 2 years. And that's not bad. That's good enough for me to burn in my fireplace. Let's see what the firewood that I split today is. So some of that was sitting in the dirt and some of that was actually sitting here on the concrete. Let's see if I can find a couple different pieces and compare the moisture of that hickory. I can tell by feeling it that this just kind of feels kind of cold, kind of damp. This one has a ton of sawdust on it. I'm gonna assume that the bugs got to it. This one was laying in the dirt. I'm gonna assume this was in the dirt. Of course, it's airing out because it's too high a moisture. It is 26% moisture on this one right here. Let me see if I can find one that was not on the ground. So this one here, when I split the firewood, I threw this one off to the side a little bit because I knew this one was on the concrete. So it was under the roof. It wasn't laying in the dirt, but it wasn't split. And it's still 23% moisture, only 3% different. And you know, a lot of that has to do is it never was split up. You got to split your wood if you want it to dry. It just dries way slower. And if you split it up, get it in smaller pieces, it just dries a lot quicker. So if I would take that wood that we just split today, even though it's almost a year old, that would not want to burn in my fireplace. That would not want to burn in that EPA approved wood stove. It's just too much moisture in it, and that takes the heat out of the stove trying to boil all the water. Basically, you're trying to boil the water out of that wood. And yeah, stuff like that will not burn in our EPA approved fireplace. So the first year we burnt wood, I tried cutting deadfall out in the woods, and we had a heck of a time getting it to burn. And everything is just so much better now that we finally have wood that's truly seasoned and nice and dry. So that one I just tested a minute ago, I split that open to test the inside of the wood just to see where it was on the inside. That's pretty much the proper way to do it. If I take one of these pieces that's just been sitting here and I test the outside, I'll probably get a lot lower reading. Yeah, so I'm closer to 13% on the outside. So 15 on the inside, 13 on the outside. So our turkey decided to come out and strut his stuff. He likes to show off for the camera. In fact, he just likes to show off anytime he hears anybody. I think he heard me talking, so he flew out of the barnyard and came over to greet me. Isn't that right? You need to get back in the barnyard. So the way I see it, the firewood over here, this is what we're gonna burn this winter. The firewood that's split and stacked back here, that's what we're gonna burn next winter. And then what we split today, and all this over here that we need to split, that's gonna be the winter after that. So right now, we're at least to the point where we're always working 2 years ahead on our firewood. That's gonna ensure it's nice and dry, and it'll burn a lot better in those EPA stoves. So let's go ahead, we're gonna load some of this up. We're gonna take it up to the house and get it stacked. Thank you. All right, we got the firewood rack all filled up, and now we're ready for some cold weather. So today actually was a nice day today. It warmed up today. It's been in the 40s today, so it was a nice day to be outside and split some firewood. But lately, the weather has been around freezing. It hovers around freezing, so during the day, it gets above freezing. At night, it gets below freezing. And that's pretty common weather for this time of year, for late November and December around here. And that's normally the time we start burning firewood. And we typically will only burn fire of an evening. So we'll light it when we get home from work. We'll light a fire about 6 o'clock at night. We'll stock it up a little bit before we go to bed. And then we'll just let it burn out every day. So we go through quite a bit of kindling. But this amount of firewood right here should last us about 2 weeks once we start burning firewood, if we're only doing an evening fire. But I thought I had some kindling split up, and I didn't see any. So I think I'm going to have to split a bunch of kindling up and get it made up, because this time of year, when you burn once a day, we go through lots of kindling. So I still got these leftover cut-off beams from our log home build. And these are white pine, and I think they make pretty good kindling. So when I get a chance to cut the length of my kindling like this, I go for about 12 inches. That way I can put it in the fireplace both directions and not just have to be able to go one direction with it. Oh, that's the wrong way. So I'm gonna cheat, I guess. Instead of using an axe, I'm just gonna use the log splitter to make kindling. Seems like cheating. Thank you. So last year I started filling up 5 gallon buckets with kindling, and that made it easy to carry back to the house. So I only found 1 5-gallon bucket. I'll have to find some more, but I've got at least one bucket here to take back to the house. And didn't that seem like easy mode? I thought that was like cheating. It's seriously, on the log splitter like that, you get a straight grain piece of wood where all the grain is perfectly straight, no knots. And man, you can just walk right through that and make little pieces of kindling pretty easy on the log splitter. I definitely have been liking using this old pine. You do get some pieces with some knots in it. It's not real pretty, but you get a good couple pieces like we had today, and it splits up really good. Easy to make it on the log splitter that way. So we only actually used two of those blocks, just two of the blocks. So I'd say each block makes about a 5 gallon bucket, and it'll be easy to come back and make more later whenever I need some more. But I've got plenty of those old beams. They're actually stacked back there behind the wood pile, and most of them are 3-4 foot long cutoffs that were left over from the log home build, and I never threw them away, so they've came in pretty handy for the kindling. Now back at the pole barn, I actually save the cutoffs of wood in there as well, and I plan on burning those as kindling or firewood also, because we're going to have a wood stove. I already bought the wood stove. We're going to put a wood stove in our pole barn and heat the workshop that way. So we will actually be burning more firewood this year. So I'm not really sure how much more we'll end up burning, but I know I've got plenty to use back here. But yeah, I keep all the, anything that's not treated lumber or glued, anything like that, that's pine or hardwood or whatever in the workshop, I keep that as well. And that'll make pretty good firewood in the workshop, or pretty good kindling. So I've spun the camera around. I've tried to adjust it so you can see the sunset. The sun was just above the horizon a couple minutes ago, and now it is set. And it's about that time of the evening when I normally call it quits and I head in and cook myself some supper. But that skyline right now, I'm not sure how well it's gonna show up in the camera, but the way those clouds are lit up, that just looks pretty cool right now. But you know, today has actually been a fairly, been a fairly fun day. I'm gonna go ahead and adjust my camera back up. You're gonna lose the sunset a little bit. But this has been a very enjoyable day for me. I like doing firewood. I like cutting it up. And I've been looking forward to this for a while. This is relaxing for me. That may sound weird, but this is stuff that I enjoy doing. There's a lot of tasks out here that you do that are kind of grueling tasks that you don't necessarily want to do. And this is actually one of the tasks that I like to do. So I've had fun today, finally getting out of here, splitting some firewood. And yeah, it's just been a beautiful day. It's just been gorgeous weather. It's been in the 40s. So very good day today. It's nice to finally have, I'm gonna call this more of a relaxing day for me. This was a good day. So I think that's it, guys. I think I'm gonna call it today. It's just, that is a beautiful sunset right now. You can't see it, but it is nice. But I think I'm gonna go ahead and call it a day today, and I'm gonna head in and start fixing myself something to eat. So I think I'm all ready to burn firewood. We've got everything prepared. And as soon as the cold weather hits, we'll finally light that first fire. But that's it for today, guys. So thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next one. All right, I'm gonna try to give you another shot of the sunset the way I see it. It's somewhere close to this. I just can't get the way those clouds look. Let me zoom in here. Oh yeah, look at that. Now that right there, that is what I am seeing. That is just cool looking. Hope you guys have a great day. Thanks for watching. So I'm gonna zoom in here. I'll show you a little more detail of these clouds. There's just a lot of shadows in there. It's a pretty cool looking sunset. It's been a good day.